Sup guys, welcome to today's show. So today we are going to define the grammar of our language. We are going to continue creating an HTML language in C, and this is an important part of creating your own language or writing a compiler. So there are different ways to define this, but I am going to do it based on something which is called Backus Nauer form. And that looks like this. So to the left we have symbols, and those symbols resolve to something on the right. So this is called a production rule. Let me just change this to BMF. So this symbol means that this to the left should be replaced to this to the right. And this line is called a production rule. And this defines the grammar of your language. And that's what you use later on when you are parsing symbols. So our minimal version of HTML will basically look like this. We will have a root symbol which is called document, and the document contains a head and a body, and this is not the HTML tag head, even though it looks similar. It is the symbol head, which contains other things. So, for instance, the head will contain the string head, followed by the symbol title and the string slash head, like this. Whereas the title, in turn, is similarly the string title followed by a string followed by the closing title tag. So this is the entire head of our minimal HTML language. Then we have the body, the symbol body, and that will in turn contain the string body, but then it gets a little bit more complicated. We will have a list of tokens, and then the ending is the ending body tag, and these curly braces means that this inside of that will be repeated. So these are several tokens. And what is a token? Well, in our case, it is either a tag or a text token. So this vertical bar, the pipe sign, will means or. So tag or text token. Whereas the tag can be, in our case, it can be either the B tag or the BR. That is the only thing we have defined thus far. The text token, well, that's just a string. And the data type string, I type like this, with a capital S and no braces around. And this means that this is not going to translate to anything. This is a top or a bottom layer kind of thing. The B tag is the string B, followed by token, one or several tokens, because this can be both text token and other tags. And then we close the B. And our BR, well, that's just the string BR, like this, indicating that this is a self-closed tag. So this is our entire language, defined in Backus Nauer form. And we're not programmatically going to use this when we parse, but we will use it as a guide when we code our parser. So you should always define the grammar in one form or another, so you have something to fall back on when you code the actual parser, which is the next logical step. If you like this episode, please like and subscribe. And thank you for watching, and thanks for today.